Hello everyone, welcome to my channel once again. So let's start with today's video, and today we are going to talk about prostate or subedural stem, and they are the part of weak stem. In last video I given you a knowledge about upright stem. Upright weak stem, they grows upright on the support with help of their weak stem or with the help of some or the other part of the plant. Now in this prostate or subaerial stem, these stems, they will grow horizontally on the ground, and with that spreading, the flowers or the parts, leaves or reproductive parts of the plant will be properly exposed. So today's topic is prostate or subaerial stem. These prostate or subaerial stem is divided into two categories. One is called trailer and other is creeper. Simple, with a small diagram I can explain you. The trailers are, this is the main plant. The new plants are coming from this, but there will be no roots at intervals. Whereas in case of creepers, you will find the main plant is there, roots are coming out of it, and when the new stems grows, from the nodes new roots are coming at interval. So here roots are not present, here roots are present. So prostate and subaerial stem grows horizontally. On ground. Second thing, exposes flowers, leaves and other parts for proper function. Fine. So if the leaves are properly exposed, sunlight will come on that, and they will be able to do photosynthesis properly. So now this creeper is divided into two categories. The number one is trailer. The characteristic feature of trailer is, again same, grows horizontally on ground. No roots, very important character, no roots at interval from nodes. And you will see such examples in case of euphorbia or tribulus. In these two plants, there are many other plants also, but in case of these two plants, such growth will be there. Trailer like modification will be there. Now second we are going to discuss is creepers. Creepers are divided into four categories. Number one, suckers, runners, stolen and offset. So these are the four categories. We are going to discuss about all these four categories one by one. Before that, the general characteristics of creeper. As the name suggests, creeps on ground. First thing. Second, roots at interval from nodes. नोड से आप देखेंगे थोड़ी थोड़ी दूर के बाद, जब भी नोड्स सॉइल के कॉन्टैक्ट में आते हैं, यू विल फाइंड एडवेंटिशियस रूट्स आर कमिंग आउट ऑफ इट. व्हाई आई एम कॉलिंग इट एज एडवेंटिशियस, बिकॉज द रूट्स आर नॉट ग्रोइंग फ्रॉम रेडिकल, दे आर ग्रोइंग फ्रॉम अदर पार्ट्स अदर देन रेडिकल. सो रूट्स एट इंटरवल फ्रॉम नोड्स. एंड द लास्ट थिंग इज, इट इज मॉडिफिकेशन of subaerial stem for the purpose. What is the purpose of modification here? Vegetative propagation. So wherever these stem are coming in contact with the soil, roots are coming. If that stem wants to be independent, they will lose the contact with the main plant and again they will grow into a new. So through the stem, if you are getting a new plant, that is called as vegetative propagation. Or if you are getting any plant from vegetative parts of the plant, is known as vegetative propagation. So stem is a vegetative part. That is why when it helps in reproduction, it is known as vegetative propagation. So here in case of creeper, the subaerial stem modifying for the purpose of vegetative propagation. So let's start with the sucker. Please take the screenshot. So let's talk about sucker. It is a non-green subaerial aerial stem and grows from base of erect stem. Let me explain through diagram. This is the soil and this is the main stem. Main stem and roots, and when these subaerial stem, as it is coming near the ground, it is growing near the ground, when it comes out, it forms a new plant, and from here you will find adventitious roots are coming out. Fine. Same. You will see like this a new plant, and as it is a creeper, so obviously from the nodes the roots will be coming out. So this will be adventitious root. You know why I am calling it as adventitious, because they are not growing from the radical, they are growing from other part rather than radical. And this non-green part, you will call it as sucker. Okay? So, as sucker comes out, it forms new aerial plant. So, new aerial plant. So, this is a vegetative propagation. You will see such kind of structure in case of mint, or you will see this in mentha, that is mint, and chrysanthemum. So these are the general characteristics of sucker. Next is runner. The next one is runner. Their characteristic is, you will find it is green. Second is that grows on the surface of the soil. Okay, then this kind of runner plant are having long internodes. And roots coming out from nodes. And even you can find axillary buds at the nodes. Example is cynodon, which can also be called as dub grass. Let me explain with the diagram. This is the main stem. The roots are coming out. Now, the runner is going horizontally on the ground, on the surface, and when it comes in contact with the soil, there the adventitious root will come out and a new plant like this. So this is again, you know, adventitious root, and this part, this green stem is known as runner. Okay, so you can easily understand here, in sucker the stem is near but below the ground, and here it is above the ground, and because of this runner a new plant is developing. That is why this is the modification of subaerial stem for the purpose of vegetative propagation. Now the next one is stolon. In case of stolon, this is the main stem, and as usual roots. In this case, the weak stem will grow little obliquely, and then the nodes come in contact with the soil. Adventitious roots are coming and you will get a new plant. So here you can see that it is going little longer, it is little elongated and it moves little obliquely. So such kind of structure is stolon, and it is adventitious root. So it is also a modification of a subaerial stem for the purpose of vegetative propagation. And you will see such a type of stems in case of strawberry and there are another plants also. Pause. The next example is jasmine. Fine. So this is stolon. The last one, the fourth type, is offset. Generally, you will see such kind of subaerial modification in aquatic habitat, but on terrestrial also you can see this. So the next is offset. Here, I am giving one example of aquatic plant. What you can see, these are the rosette of leaves. Rosette of leaves, from that there are bunch of group of leaves. Below that rosette of leaf, the weak stem is coming out, and from that other roots, adventitious roots are coming, and you will see other rosette of leaves there. So you can see this offset is just one internode long. I have taught you here that these are the rosette of leaves. From there, a internode or a weak stem will come out, which is just one internode long, and this offset will be short and thickened. Fine. Uski thickness zyada hogi, and from there, as soon as again it comes in contact with water, the adventitious roots will come out, and again a rosette of leaves will be growing from there. Example of aquatic example is Pistia and Icornia, which is also known as water hyacinth. So this is about the offset. So we had to talk about creepers, the four different type of creepers, and these four different types of creepers are having modification for the purpose of vegetative propagation. So in all four types, I have shown you how the new plants are growing from these weak stems. As soon as these weak stems come in contact with the soil, they are going to develop adventitious root, and from there a new plant will develop. So this is all about today's lecture. In the next lecture, I will start with a new topic. Till then, keep learning. Take care. Goodbye.